Now that's what Spider-Man 2099 should be able to do out of the box without modifications. What's up, YouTube? It's Mike, aka Plastic Life, and I'm back with an action figure modification this time. So I recently received the SH figure Spider-Man 2099. It's a beautiful figure with great likeness to Miguel in the movie Across the Spider-Verse. I really love the aesthetics of this figure, but I'm not going to review the figure today. I'm going to address what is, in my opinion, a major problem with the figure. This thing cannot bend forward very far. So it makes those awesome Spider-Man crouching poses impossible. I'm going to go through two modifications, a simple one and a more complex one, to help you get more range of motion in the abdomen region of this Spider-Man 2099. Please keep in mind, before you attempt any of these modifications, just know that you may end up breaking your figure. So please, don't attempt this if you're not confident in your ability to modify figures. With that said, let's go over the tools that you'll need and how to perform these modifications. So for the first modification, you're just going to need a hairdryer and a pair of pliers. So the problem with the articulation lies in the dumbbell joint that goes from the lower torso to the upper torso. So what we need to do is just pull this figure apart, like so, revealing the double ball peg or dumbbell joint with a little ring around the lower part. This prevents movement forward and back and left and right. So the only movement comes from the upper part of the torso up here, which is very limited. We need to remove this dumbbell and flip it upside down. We're gonna need a lot of heat to get this out because there is a potential for the capsule to break there. So we wanna make sure that this is heated enough. I'm gonna use my hairdryer. Once you've heated it up for about 45 seconds or so, clamp onto it with your pliers and try to pull out. If it's not pulling out, then you're going to need to apply some more heat. There we go. And just make sure that the socket is not damaged. So, taking a look at that, you can see this little ring around there. So all we need to do is basically just flip this dumbbell joint upside down and port it back in and then reassemble the figure. I'm gonna just apply some more heat just to get the ball joint back in there. So once you get enough heat there to pop that joint back into place, you're just gonna reassemble the figure, like so. And then you immediately have much more range of motion. So you can stop right there. I already think this is good enough, but because I said in this video that I'm gonna go and make this even more articulated, I'm gonna take it one step further. So hopefully if you attempted this modification, you got it successful and you didn't break your figure, and now your Miguel can bend forward quite a lot now. So you can get him into much more dynamic poses now with the modification done. Just something to keep in mind, once you've done this modification, you run the risk of, when you bend forward, scratching up the abdomen. So make sure there's enough clearance when you go to bend it. Also, on the back now you have a gap when you bend forward. So you need to make sure that you just push in a little bit as you bend backwards, because you don't want this lip to get caught on the upper torso and then bend it forward. So just make sure that everything aligns up when you're bending. Okay, so if you're still not happy with the range of motion you get from flipping this dumbbell peg upside down, we're gonna actually remove all of this circle here. So to do that, we're gonna need a pair of cutters. This is just cutters that you can use for modeling. And some sandpaper. I got some 100 grit sandpaper here just to take down and smooth that out. Do not attempt this if you're not confident. This is where a lot of things can go wrong. So I'm going to start by trimming all the way around this circle until I've removed most of the bulk. And just keep an eye on it. I think my peg is starting to whiten a little bit, so I just need to be mindful of that while I'm trimming this. Once you've trimmed around most of the bulk, that's when you're going to start using the sandpaper to smooth it out. So I've gotten rid of most of the bulk here, and I'm just going to use my sandpaper and make it nice and smooth. I'm going to avoid touching the ball peg though at the top there, so I'm basically just going to be sanding around there. I'm going to do this off camera so I can focus, and then I'll pop back on and show you what it looks like. Alright, so after removing the bulk of the circle there, I'm left with this. I'm not going to sand it much more because I'm starting to get into the ball peg, but let's reassemble this and see how it goes. Alright, so we got the peg back in there, and let's just reassemble the figure, like so. And we got even more range of motion now. So I'm pretty happy with that modification and how it came out. Let me know if you're going to attempt this. Like I said, just be really careful when attempting this, because you can break your figure. Be wary of the gaps now that you have. So just realign, make sure that you avoid scratching the paint on the front there. And be careful, if you see any whitening in the peg, just stop what you're doing. You're more likely going to break it at that point. You might want to add a little bit of silicone shock oil, just a tiny, tiny little bit, so that the joint's not so tight after reassembling it. And yeah, hopefully this works out for you and you're able to modify your 2099. Please, again, use extreme caution when doing this. This is an expensive figure, and I don't want you breaking things, and don't blame me if you break your figure.